coming in hot. How everybody doing tonight? This is a wonderful metaphor for stand-up comedians. We're for a series of bad decisions and impulses. I doubt either of us would be here.
Wrong place, wrong time.
Oh yeah. Well, I'm from Lynchburg. Are most people from Lynchburg here? There's one guy from Richmond I know. Have you ever seen Get Out? The movie Get Out? Well, you're like me, you're out of town, I'm gonna ask you. Where are you from? You say? Roanoke, obviously. Because Nazis ruined Charlottesville. That's what I used to say. And you know, look, Lynchburg's known for like two things outside of our local bubble. It's founding with the moral majority and inventing enemies. So I feel like it's kind of redundant. But only in Lynchburg has the next bit happened. I was a few years ago, and I experienced a pain in my member. So I went to the doctor like a rational human being, and I was prescribed a Bible.
Okay.
I didn't get a free sample, but I took a Bible and I rubbed it head to toe for like 2 or 3 weeks, Genesis to Revelations. And somehow I still had the clap. But, you know,
wait, who's got the clap?
It's not all sour grapes, pun intended. I think it's pretty impressive that a medical professional can look at me and tell that I had a pagan dick. It was the equinox, and it was a little uncomfortable. Sometimes I get rashes on solstice, but it's converted now. I got that tax-exempt member. And, let's see what's next. I have a drunken list of material. Yeah, that's how you do it. All right. I feel like our values are warped in this country because I see homeless people out in the streets without a place to live, without food to eat. And I can go to Biscuitville and get biscuits shaped like bones for my dogs. Dogs are up on that totem pole now. Yeah. And they should be. I like dogs. I'm not like a dog hater or something, but it's interesting to me that a few months ago, there was a school shooting in Florida. Another school shooting. And people in the community are trying to step in and regulate something with the government. Like, hey, you know, move towards a solution. It's been like 3 months. I don't know what regulate means, but it's probably something important. And around the same time, a dog died on an airline, like on an airplane in the luggage department. And within 48 hours, the airline issued an apology and a solution. It's been 3.5 months, and the government hasn't said anything about school shootings. So I have a solution. We need to think of the children here. We need to take dogs, apparently, and shoot them on school campuses. Hold on. They should be like old yeller dogs that need to be put down anyway. We can make it economical here. I'm not a monster, you know? And the other angle of that, stuffing kids into the luggage compartments on airplanes, is proven counterproductive. And, you know, fur babies are big these days. I have a kid, no fur baby. But there's a lot of similarities I've noticed. This is from me. There's a lot of similarities I've noticed. Well, when they're a toddler, they play with, like, the same toys. As inconvenient as it is for an animal to use a bathroom inside, it's just as inconvenient for your toddler to use a bathroom outside. One key difference I've noticed is that every time I drop my kids off in the woods across town, she always finds her way home. I'm just kidding. She never makes it back. Never made it back.